Imagine you meet Harry Styles outside of a One Direction concert. He falls in love with you.
You meet Harry Styles walking down the street, and his big green eyes meet your big blue ones. He falls in love with you.
You meet Harry Styles in a coffee shop. He pays for your coffee and touches your hair.
He falls in love with you.
Your mother sells you to One Direction for rent money. Harry Styles is in charge of feeding and walking you. He falls in love with you.
Imagine you are a beautiful model down on your luck. Harry Styles is a photographer who sees your potential. He captures your image and your heart. He falls in love.
Imagine your father sells you to One Direction for drug money. Harry Styles is in charge of cleaning your cell every week. He falls in love.
Harry Styles is your gynecologist. He tells you you have an STI. He falls in love with you.
Imagine, you are a young woman between the ages of 16 and 29 living in Northern California in the late 60s/early 70s. Harry Styles is the Zodiac Killer. You meet in San Francisco. He falls in love with you.
You crash your car into a ditch. Harry Styles finds you almost dead with your head split open. He uses his shirt to stop the blood. You pass out when you see him shirtless. He carries you out of the ditch with one hand and shouts for help. No one comes, and you die. Your ghost watches Harry crying over your dead body. Your ghost possesses the nearest living creature, a worm, writhing in the dirt next to your corpse. Even though you are now a worm, you can speak with your own voice. You scream, "Hello, it is me, the beautiful girl from the ditch," to Harry. He picks you up gently with his big hands. He wonders how he will make it work with a worm. He likes the feeling of your smooth, wormy skin on his palm. He falls in love with you.
Imagine Harry crawls into your ear and his eggs in your brain. You try to get him out, but he is in there.
Imagine Harry is your teacher.
Imagine Harry is your therapist.
Imagine Harry is the president of the United States.
Imagine Harry is an alien from an undiscovered planet where everyone looks like Harry Styles.
Harry is Jesus. You are both Mary and Joseph, and God.
Imagine Harry is God. You are created in his image, and you can never be ugly.
Harry is God. You are Eve. Adam is killed. first chapter.
Imagine. Harry likes kinky sex and long walks on the beach. You are still the worm lying in the ditch by the side of the road you never meet, and Harry marries a girl he met at a One Direction concert.
Imagine, Harry's in a band. You are in high school. You think about him every second of every day. You write his name in the margins of your notebook and on your desk. In pencil when you're feeling kind, and in pen when you're feeling brave. You lick the posters of his face on the wall above your bed. You touch yourself and picture Harry at the foot of your bed, curled up and watching you like a cat. You think about him when you brush your teeth, when you run your tongue over the inside of your mouth. You decide you love him from everywhere, even from your braces, especially from your braces. You hold him on the tip of your tongue while you sleep, like a little secret.
Cowgirl Summer. A Harry Styles play. A romantic comedy. A fantasy in parts. Part 1. Telepathy isn't real, except when it actually is.
A high school library, 4 p.m. Sleepy, late afternoon sun shines in through the windows. School is long over, and almost everyone has gone home, except two girls, tucked away in the corner behind shelves of Folger Shakespeare plays and obscure YA novels covered in plastic. They sit on once colorful beanbags, now riddled with unidentifiable stains and puncture wounds, out of which tiny white beads come tumbling sadly onto the carpeted floor. Resting between the girls is a cracked iPhone 4, facing screen up and open to the voice memo app. They lean in close to each other to speak conspiratorially, with the kind of intensity that comes naturally to high school freshmen and adults find uncomfortable. Across the room, far enough away to be out of earshot, but close enough to be a threat, sits the school librarian, glasses balanced precariously on the end of her sweaty, old woman nose, pretending to read a book that may as well be upside down for all the attention she's paying it. An ancient analog clock ticks loudly on the wall. It's getting late.
You're being a child.
I'm not doing it. Not here, not now.
I will build a fort of beanbags around you.
No.
I will shield you from all harm. I will take care of you. Let mommy take care of you.
No.
She won't see anything.
She'll hear.
So let her.
And risk getting expelled?
We wouldn't get expelled. What is this, Hogwarts?
Expulsion happens in real life, you freak.
But not to me. Not to us. She loves us.
She loves you. I'm not doing it.
Have I ever told you how much I appreciate you?
I'm not doing it.
Not even for art.
This isn't art. This is borderline pornography. I'm not fucking doing it.
That's not very sex positive of you.
You don't even know what that means. You read that on Tumblr.
Not true, ugly. I just happen to be a very sex positive person.
You're a virgin.
I don't have to have had sex to be a sex positive person.
Then you do it.
What?
If you're so sex positive, why don't you let me do the slapping?
Because that's your job. Sounds like your job. I have to be reading my lines.
You don't have any lines during this part. You're being fucked on a tractor.
Yes, but I have to be, like, ad-libbing and stuff. Like, all of the, yes, daddy, please, daddy, harder, faster, more shit.
And you can't do both of those things simultaneously?
Well, I could, but you have a better ass for slapping.
That's a lie. I have dad's ass and you know it.
I love your ass. It is the perfect ass. It's soft, like baby bell cheese.
Why are you always comparing my body to food?
Your ass is like the ass I wish I had.
Really?
Yeah.
Thanks.
You're welcome. I mean it, booby. Turn around.
Can we please wait until we get home?
But we're on a roll here. We can't stop now. This is gold. It's so, so good.
It's just saying that.
No, I'm not. Your writing is like quietly beautiful, like when a ladybug lands on your shoulder.
I think it could use some work in terms of structure.
No one cares about structure. Structure is irrelevant. And you just wrote it today, so.
But that's what I mean. I think it needs time.
No way. If you edit, you lose all the rawness.
The rawness? Like the sex stuff?
No, more than that. Like, yes, the sex, but also the energy between them. Harry looking her in the eyes for the first time. The corn. The fun. fucking corn, Teresa. Shh. Oh my god.
You like the corn? I wasn't sure.
Yes. The corn is necessary. The corn is the heart of the story for me.
It is pretty hot.
Very hot. The sound for that should just be like a huge bucket of phloem, and one of us will just penetrate it like elbow deep with a squish when the corn goes inside her.
Oh, God.
Fuck, that's good. I wish we had phloem right now.
I'll make a note in the binder.
Although I guess it would be more like a squeak. Like a...
Melanie.
Sorry. You're right. I'm getting ahead of myself. Give me your ass.
Mel, I'm not going to give you my ass.
But I want it.
Can you slap my arm or something?
It won't sound as authentic.
All flesh sounds the same when you slap it.
Wrong. If I were to slap your face right now, it would sound different. Less wiggly.
Jesus Christ.
Teresa, the podcast was your idea.
I know it was, but I didn't
Don't you want it to be good? Don't you want people to listen to it and like it and make us famous?
I don't know. I thought it would be less about the sex and more about, like, the story. Like, plot-driven, I guess.
Nobody gets off to plot.
I do.
Well, you're an anomaly, to use a vocab word. I love you, but this needs to be sexy or no one will care.
I can be sexy.
Prove it.
Look, I'm not saying I will do this, but I care about this podcast and I care about you.
I care about you too, Stinky, so much.
And I care about this story because women and whatever.
And Harry Styles.
Women and Harry Styles, exactly.
The two food groups.
What?
Nothing. Continue.
We flip a coin. We flip a coin for the ass slapping.
Fine. Heads, I slap your ass. Tails, you slap mine.
Deal.
I think I have one in my bag.
Hell.
Oh yeah, baby, slap city.
This is the worst day of my life.
So I think what needs to happen is you squat down a little bit and I'll hold the phone with my other hand.
Are you gonna make the sounds too?
Yeah, I can do both.
You're gonna have to have your face like jammed up against my asshole.
Look, we don't have any other options. And I've seen your ass before. Relax.
I hate this.
Actually, I've probably had my face this close to your ass before. In the womb.
Okay, well, I wasn't a conscious fucking human being when we were sharing a room, so I don't have memories of that.
I do.
What? No, you don't.
I do. I remember. I was like, hey, Teresa. That's my fetus voice. I was like, hey, Teresa, your ass is so dummy thick, it's getting in the way of me trying to grow all my fingers and toesies.
Oh, fuck off. Can we please just get this over with?
Ready when you are, babe.
Okay. Turn around.
You're joking.
Do it.
I'm gonna see it anyway.
Please.
Fine. Weirdo.
Do you have the phone ready?
Yes. What underwear are you wearing?
Shut up. Is she looking?
Hang on. Nope. She's elbow deep in a bag of pretzels right now.
It's gonna be so cold on my skin.
Ass, 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 ass. Time to slap my sister's ass for our podcast.
Should I move further behind the shelf?
You're fine. She's not looking. I don't even think that she knows we're here. Just do it.
Okay.
Did you do it?
Yes. Shut up!
Sorry.
I'm not gonna do this if you don't take it seriously.
No, I'm taking it seriously. It's just, it's funny. Can I poke it?
I will kill you.
Okay, here we go.
Wait.
What?
Can we do a test run?
Why? Are you afraid I'll hurt you?
No, but we should make sure it's not gonna be too loud or too quiet. Everybody does a test run. It's professional.
All right, fine. Here it comes.
Ow, fuck!
Oh, too hard. Too hard?
Are you me. Sorry. Joking?
I'm sorry, it was pretty funny though. It did a cute wiggle.
I was gonna leave a handprint. I will end you.
Please don't end me, Papa. I said I'm sorry.
I'm done. This is done.
No, wait, let's do it again. I'll be softer this time, I swear. You won't even feel it. Please.
No.
I swear on Harry's third. And fourth nipple.
Swear on all four.
Okay. I swear on all four nipples that it will be the softest, lightest slap you've ever felt.
Fine. I need you to take it down to a one to start. A one, Melanie.
I got it. Ready?
Go. Okay. That's fine. You could do it a little harder.
How's this?
That's good, yeah.
Okay. That sounds good, right?
I think so. I don't really know. Try it with the sounds.
Ugh. thought was weird.
It was fucking weird, dude.
I know.
I told you it would be.
I didn't realize it would be like...
Why do you never listen
I'm
to me?
I'm sorry, okay?
I can feel my heartbeat in my ass.
We don't
ass.
Have to do it again.
We are not doing it again. Are you kidding me? No way we are ever doing that again.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Whatever. It's okay. You don't have to pout about it. Melanie, it's really fine.
T, come here. Listen to this.
Teresa sits next to Melanie, and they listen to what they just recorded.
Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh my god.
We got it.
Oh, yeah, we so fucking did.
See, I told you.
This could be really good.
I know.
Holy shit.
We're basically God. We just made this happen.
You're absolutely right. We need way more of this. We can't put out the episode yet until we record more.
You think?
Yeah, I'm rethinking the whole plot now. I'm restructuring.
Oh, she's a writer. She's writing in her head. She's making it all happen.
Hand me the laptop.
Yes, yes, yes.
Truck ice cream, this stuff that is shaped like Tweety Bird or SpongeBob with gumballs for eyes, except instead of cartoon characters, it's Harry Styles' face. You buy one just to hold until his features melt down your fingers. Down your fingers.
Size of Harry Styles' hands makes you wonder how much of them could fit inside you. You frame a picture of just his hands and put it on your bedside table.
Twins huddled over a shared laptop. They link hands.
Are we ready?
You're squeezing my hand too hard.
I am fucking ready.
Melanie, stop squeezing!
Sorry.
Okay, I'm ready.
Melanie uploads the podcast. Suddenly, the comments come flooding in.
Bubble tea ho. Hey, Wyoming! I'm from there.
Oops, tattoo. OMG, this is so
muffins are just ugly cupcakes. Yeah. Technically speaking, I don't think the corn would go in that easily. I've tried a variety of vegetables.
What's up, babes? Cool
like
content. Check out my new video. Like and subscribe. Hugs and kisses.
411. Just fuck already. I want to see
Curly
it.
Curly boy 1998. Is Harry going to sex her in the field? I need the new chapter.
Teresa notices a message.
Your voice is amazing. Would love to talk to you. Message me.
Library. The next day.
How many now?
Since you asked me 30 seconds ago, still 209.
How many good?
You know how many.
Read it to me again.
200 good. Vast majority are good.
And 9 bad.
9 bad, but you made me put the one where they called us sex witches in a bad category, and I still think that's a compliment.
Refresh the page.
Melanie, there are still two...
Refresh la page.
210.
Read it to me!
It's still loading. Would you please calm down?
Read!
It just says foot.
Foot?
Just foot.
Do you think that's good or bad?
I think it's nothing. I think it's someone being annoying.
Maybe it's a fetish thing.
There are no mention of foot fetish in our story. That makes no sense.
Then maybe we should put feet in our story. It's easy enough to do. Isn't toe sucking a huge thing? Should Harry suck on her toes? Or no, probably she should suck on his toes. It'll give her something to do after the corn.
Melanie, no.
Why not? Give the people what they want.
You can't just throw a foot fetish in because Spicy Boy 123 may or may not be into feet. It compromises the integrity of our content.
Stop talking like that. You know I hate that.
And you know I'm right.
If there's a chance this guy would listen to another chapter if we put in some feet shit, then we are going to put in some feet shit.
You don't even know if that's what he meant.
What else could it be?
I don't know. A mistake? I'm gonna ask him.
No, stop that.
What are you doing?
You cannot talk to any of these people. Especially not Footboy.
But I want to talk to Footboy. I'm very invested in Footboy now.
No. Promise me you won't message anyone.
Why?
Theresa, babe, there are 200 people who love us.
No, they love what we're making.
And then 200 people love you. You're basically a celebrity.
You think so?
I know so. Which means we have to remain mysterious or they will get bored of us.
So we can't talk to any of them because if they got to know us, they wouldn't like us anymore?
No. Yes. When you said it, it sounded sad. Why do you make everything sad?
I want to talk to them. Some of them have questions that I can answer.
No!
Ow, you're hurting me! Give it back!
Give it to me or I will put my tongue in your eyeball!
No, you won't, you coward!
Here I come!
Ah, fine! Here! You are a nightmare.
I know. You can't talk to any of them because they might be dangerous.
What?
We don't know who any of them are. It's not safe.
Oh my god.
I'm serious. I've read about it.
And where have you read about it?
Online.
You sound like you're 50 years old. Are we going to be cyber-stalked? Do we need to protect our location, Grandma?
Teresa, this is important.
Are you genuinely worried about this?
He could send you unsolicited pictures of his feet.
Dear God, I hope he sends the unsolicited feet pics. I pray for that to happen.
Teresa, you have to promise
You're being very intense right now. Okay. Whatever. I promise.
Refresh the page.
Much later, Teresa alone. She stares at the message from before.
Your voice is amazing. Would love to talk to you. Message me.
What's up? How's it hanging?
Teresa deletes the message.
Hey.
Hey. Winky face. Sorry, didn't mean to send the winker face, it was a hippo. Winky. I meant typo.
Do you mean typo?
I love your voice. You sound like you've done this before.
I haven't. This is our first podcast, actually.
You and your sister?
Yeah.
Cool that you were friends.
Yeah, she's the worst, but... Yeah, it is. We're twins, so we kind of have to be.
Oh my god, so fun! I want a twin. I would make her dress like me and talk like me so that if in case I died, I would never actually die because she would be alive. Sorry if that's weird.
No, it's okay. Sometimes we can speak telepathically.
What do you say to each other?
It only happens sometimes. We can't really control it, but sometimes we'll just say the same thing at the same time, or I'll guess what she's about to say before she actually says it.
Try and guess what I'm about to type. Are you ready?
What?
We are going to speak telepathetically. Okay, I'm thinking about it. Go.
Dancing?
No, guess again.
That's not really how telepathy works.
Guess again.
Ice cream.
Wrong.
I don't know. I'm bad at guessing. Sorry.
It was you.
You were thinking about me?
Yes.
Why?
I like your voice.
Thank you. What's your name?
Lily. It's nice to meet you, Melanie.
Oh, I'm the other one. I do the Harry voice.
You should help your sister figure out her voice, though, when she's being the Harry parts. She doesn't sound like him. Are you still there? Hello?
I'm here. Sorry. I'll tell her.
It should be deeper. She sounds too much like a girl.
Well, she's a... Totally. I'll help her.
How old are you?
14. 15.
Oh. I'm 17.
Oh, I'm so... Well, my birthday is soon, so I'm about to be 16.
Oh, okay. For a second, I thought you were baby.
Oh no, don't worry, I'm very mature for my age. Everyone says so. I feel like that was a stupid thing to say. I'm sorry.
No, don't apologize. It was cute. Thanks for messaging me, Melanie. I like hearing your voice and picturing what you look like.
What do you think I'd look like?
Imagine. You are a witch who lives in a hut by the sea.
You brew potions to make beautiful boys fall in love with you, but it's been years since a pretty man has passed by your neck of the woods.
Sea. Your neck. Your section of the sea. The part of the beach where your hut is, where nobody else goes.
It's rocky and dangerous, and everybody tells their kids not to go there because they could fall and break their head open on the rocks.
But Harry Styles doesn't listen. He stumbles by your home looking like a merman who was granted legs.
And what amazing legs they are! Long and hairy, covered in tattoos.
You invite him into your home and give him the strongest potion you have.
He falls in love with you, obviously.
Imagine. Harry Styles is a vampire from your hometown. You are a pretty girl, also from your hometown. Nobody knows Harry and his family are all secret vampires, but you know, because you're smarter and better than everyone else, and you figure it out based on context clues. He wants your blood. He wants your blood so bad. Sometimes when he's done feeding, he has blood on his lips, and it gets in his long, curly hair, and you want to shove your hand in it and get all tangled in the hair and the blood of him that's close to you and the blood. Lots of sexy blood.
Imagine. You are in preschool playing hopscotch on the playground, and the corners of your mouth are sticky with apple juice from snack time. Harry Styles is your preschool teacher, and he wipes away the sticky stuff with a napkin. You want him to touch your skin again, but you know you shouldn't.
Library, after school. Teresa studying a Harry Styles interview.
Hi, I'm Harry, and I'm here with Heat World, and I'm going to be answering some of your questions from Twitter. The first question is from Rachel Askin, and she wants me to describe my dream girl. I think someone that's funny, someone that's a nice person, and has a nice smile. Something like that. That'll do.
Someone that's funny, fun shit.
Hi, I'm Harry, and I'm here with
I am Harry, and I'm here with
Chapter 2, bitch!
Did you grab the highlighters?
What?
I can't do it if I don't highlight my lines. I need to be able to highlight my lines for my process.
Don't you have, like, 8?
I like the colored ones they have in the printer room. I like the purple.
It doesn't matter what color.
Will you please go get them, please, for
me?
Fine,
but just because you said please.
Deeper, rounder, stronger, like a sexy punch in the gut. Yeah!
Well, now I'm going to be answering some of your questions from Twitter.
I'm going to be answering some of your questions from Twitter. Twitter. A punch that you never see coming. Hi, I'm Harry, and I'm here with...
Random thought, as I was retrieving your purple. You think that new kid with the avatar hair wants to fuck me? I didn't think so at first, just because he kind of stares like that at everyone, and I was like, okay, he's just like that. But then today, at lunch, before you sat down, he stared at me and, like, wiggled his eyebrows, and he also could have winked. or it was a twitch, like a facial twitch. People sometimes have facial twitches. Doesn't matter because I would never have sex with him. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Was that Harry?
No, it was Mick Jagger, young Mick Jagger.
No, it wasn't. Why are you watching that interview? That's from like 8 million years ago. He's a fetus in that interview.
It was just nothing.
Can I see it?
No.
You're hiding something. What are you hiding, sweaty?
I'm not. It was homework. It was a slideshow. It was porn.
No, it wasn't. You don't watch porn.
You don't know that.
We share a laptop, so I do know. Best gay movie kisses on YouTube doesn't qualify, babe.
Oh my god.
You should really clear the search history when you give it back to me.
I only watch that because it's funny. It's comedy. I watch it. Shut up. Ah.
Okay, calm down. I don't judge.
You just did. You just judged me right then. That's what that was.
No, it wasn't. Also, not the point. What are you hiding?
I'm not. It was just... Jesus Christ, can I not have one thing I don't share with you?
No.
It was research for the podcast.
What, like writing stuff? Like sex research?
No, it was for me. I just want to sound more like him, that's all. I don't want to sound stupid when we record those parts. I have a girl's voice. It sounds like I'm faking it.
You are faking it.
I know, but I don't want it to sound like I am. I want it to be authentic.
Oh. Can I hear it?
No.
What? Why? I'm gonna hear it eventually.
I feel weird about it.
Why?
Because it's... I don't know. It makes me feel weird. He's like so... Ugh. He's like the whole reason for everything. All that we're doing. I just feel like I'm way too boring to pull this off.
Teresa, it's exactly because you're boring that you can pull this off.
Thanks.
Why do you think you're the one reading for him?
Because you made me write you in as a character.
Besides that, you are a perfect blank canvas. Anything can come out of you or go into you.
Not helping.
I have too much personality. When you meet me, I'm immediately like, hey, look at me. I'm obnoxious.
True.
But you, no one expects it. Hearing his voice come out of you, it's like a punch that you never see coming.
What?
I said it's like a punch that you never...
I literally was just saying that like 2 seconds before you came back.
No.
Yes.
Spooky twin shit.
Spooky twin shit.
Okay, a count of three, we say the same word.
One, two, three. Elephant. Minge.
Damn.
Minge? Are you kidding?
Okay, elephant. We weren't even talking about
elephants.
We
weren't talking about minge either.
I was sending you major minge vibes telepathically.
All right, well, they were not received.
You received no minge.
Not a pube.
Gross. Where do you feel it?
Feel what?
Harry, his voice, where do you feel it?
In my toes.
Really?
Yeah, like tingling my pinkies, my whole leg, really, but mostly concentrated in my toes.
I feel it in my minge.
Of course you do.
I'm serious, though, like straight in my downstairs.
You feel everything down there.
I do. I like it, though. You become more in touch with the world, more sensitive to the earth spinning on its axis when you feel all your feelings from your pelvis region. It's like the body's own axis, and we all spin on it all the time.
I think my axis is off.
Your axis is non-existent.
I know. Am I weird? Does that make me weird?
A little bit, yeah. You know what I've been thinking of, actually? It's like if you channeled the scent of vanilla sugar. It's like if a vanilla sugar-scented candle had a voice, and that voice came from your pelvis.
Ooh, yeah, it's like, for me, it's like a multicolored pack of highlighters in perfect condition.
Oh my god, you nerd!
A multicolored pack of highlighters you wanna fuck!
Okay, better. I have an idea. Start talking.
What?
Do your hairy voice and I'll give you prompts. We're gonna bring it out of your weird, tense little body because I know it's in there.
You don't know. I have layers of junk and bullshit in there. It won't just happen magically.
Do you trust me, Bubble Butt?
Yes, but...
Close your eyes.
What should I say?
Anything. Just start with, my name is Harry Styles.
Okay. What are you gonna do? Is this some spooky twin shit?
Shh. Just close your eyes. Drop into it. I'll talk at you. And when I'm done... You do your voice.
Hit me.
So, to me it sounds like you're underwater, in the ocean. You went deep sea diving to discover the creatures that we don't have names for yet. Your webbed feet hit the sand at the bottom of the sea, the bottom of the earth, and it kicks up around you. And the water is so heavy, you feel like your skin is going to split apart. And just when it gets unbearable, when you feel like you can't breathe anymore, a creepy crawly comes floating towards you out of the darkness. And it's a horse. A glowing white horse with beautiful black eyes. And it's so beautiful, you start crying and float into its arms, and you're healed.
My name is Harry Styles.
That's good. That's almost there.
You think?
Shh, we're going again. Okay. It's like looking directly at a firefly at night.
My name is Harry Styles.
It's like an endless supply of watermelon at a barbecue. Like the juice just running down your chin, into your hair.
My name is Harry Styles.
Like sinking slowly into quicksand.
Melanie moves closer to Theresa.
So slowly that you see an entire day pass in front of you as more of you disappears. Like watching the sun set in glorious pink and yellow and orange, just as your face is pulled down into the ground forever.
My name is Harry Styles.
Like being kids, like 4 or 5 years old, our old bedroom with the glow-in-the-dark stars on the ceiling.
My name.
Like sleeping next to you when sleeping alone was too scary. Like being warm under the blanket. Like the freedom to suck your thumb before mom told you that you had to stop, before you knew it was a little kid thing to do.
Melanie slowly puts her thumb in Teresa's mouth.
My name is Harry Styles, bitch.
Holy shit!
What I look for in a girl is someone who's funny. Someone who will suck my dick in a park or an alley or in my dressing room after the show.
Oh my god! Oh shit.
Melanie's nose starts bleeding. A lot.
Teresa, wait, my nose is bleeding. Get me tissues. Fuck, help!
What? Oh god, here. Jesus Christ, you're spewing! That's disgusting!
I'm dying!
Hold on, I think I have tampons in my bag.
Ugh.
Stop moaning! Pinch the bridge of your nose! Are you pinching it?
Fuck you! Yes, I'm pinching it! Can you hurry up, please?
Calm down, you're fine.
Wait, hold on. Okay, yeah, it's coming out of both now, fast and furious.
Maybe they're in my pencil case?
Oh, it's spreading into... It ran into my mouth!
Found them!
Unwrap the plastic.
I did.
I can't see over the tissues. Also, I'm going blind from the blood loss and the trauma, just so you know. Your Harry Styles voice is so good, it made me bleed. How did you do that?
I don't know. And you're not going blind. Give me a single second, please. Stand over the trash can.
You have to move me there. I can't fucking see.
Just, oh my god, lean a little to the left, stick your neck out, and drop the tissues. Then I'll shove them in.
Am I over the trash can?
Yes, just do it.
I'm nervous.
Why?
What if I bleed out?
Are you kidding me?
Okay, I'm doing it. Shut up. Okay, go. Ow!
Sorry, are they in?
Yeah, they're in, but you practically punched me, booger.
Okay, well, you were the one worried about bleeding out, so...
I feel like a walrus with these strings hanging out of my nose holes. How do I look?
Like a walrus.
A beautiful tusks.
Wait, no, you look like that one dog.
What?
You know that picture of the dog who has, like, brown micro bangs and glasses?
No? Also, fuck you!
And his nose is really stretched out. Hold on, I'll find it. Come here.
Okay, yeah, I see it, but I don't have micro bangs.
I didn't say that.
I'm tired. I think it's the blood loss. Do you think something's wrong with me?
No, drink some water.
Drink some water?
I'm serious, it'll help.
Are these super?
What?
The tampons, are they regular or super?
Oh, super.
Shit, they hurt.
That means they're doing their job.
My holes are stretching.
Ew, don't say it like that.
Getting wide as hell over here.
Stop.
Do you think I'll get toxic shock?
In your nose?
Yeah, like what happens if I leave these in too long and my body freaks out?
That's not how that works. If you just relax, you'll be able to take them out soon.
Promise?
Promise.
Okay. Thank you for making sure I didn't just die now.
You were never gonna die. But you're welcome.
Can I put my head in your lap?
I think we should get back to-
Yay, thank you.
You have dried blood all over your face.
Is it sexy?
No, it looks like you've been punched.
That could be sexy.
It's not. Oh god, it's on your neck too.
I told you I was bleeding out. This is all your fault.
I'm sorry, I wasn't trying to- Sorry. It was pretty fucking cool though.
It was amazing. You summoned a nosebleed with the power of your voice. Teresa, you were hot!
Shut up.
No, you were.
You look terrible. I feel like I'm cradling a dying woman.
Ooh, yeah, that's good. I'm a beautiful, sexy, dying woman.
What are you dying of?
Consumption.
And I'm your mother. Overcome with grief, I curse the heavens for taking you so young. I shake my fist at the sky.
No, you're my lover, and I'm reaching up to stroke your face one last time.
It's raining.
Light sprinkle or heavy pour?
Heavy. And loud, we're on a cobblestone street.
It's midnight.
Yes!
And just before you slip away.
I just can't hold on much longer. Blood, 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 blood.
I say, look me in the eyes.
Wait, do your hairy voice.
Are you sure?
Yes, do it, do it, do it.
Look me in the eyes. I will always love you. I have always loved you. I've loved you in all my past lives and will love you in all my future ones. That's a promise.
Swear by the stars?
I swear by the stars and the moon and the spaceship the government has probably disguised as the moon to cover up the existence of aliens.
Oh, Harry.
Are you afraid?
A little.
Don't be. Hold my hand.
I'm getting blood on your shirt.
Do you want me to take it off?
Yes, hurry, I'm dying.
Rip shirt in half.
Rip shirt in half?
It's a thin shirt.
Oh.
Can I kiss you one last time?
Wait, tell me why you love me.
You're beautiful.
Yes, but why?
Because you're sexy.
Yes, but why?
Because whenever I have to imagine a girl in my head, I imagine you. There is no one like you.
There's no one like me. There's no one in the whole fucking world like me.
Goodbye, my love.
And then you kiss me.
What?
What?
Harry kisses you.
Yeah, and then Harry kisses me. That's what I said.
You said
something. And it's soft and sweet and perfect, just like I've always imagined it would be.
Hey.
Yeah?
There's no one in the whole fucking world like you.
I know. That's good, actually. We should put that in.
Imagine, Harry Styles is holding you by your ankles above a swimming pool filled with leeches. The blood is rushing to your head and your fingers are just brushing the surface of the water. Would you believe it? You learn to swim, or you make peace with drowning, says Harry solemnly. He lets go.
Imagine a Harry Styles shaped pinata spinning on your ceiling above your bed. If it breaks, the sun gets sucked into a giant black hole. You have a baseball bat and poor impulse control.
Harry Styles enters you in a competitive tickling competition. The video of you being tickled goes viral. Your life is ruined, and you can't stop laughing.
Theresa, alone, hunched over the laptop. It's dark. She has been talking to Lily for hours.
Space or time travel?
Time. I go back to the dinosaurs and watch the ball die.
I choose space. I want to be the one to discover aliens.
No breathing in space.
Yes, breathing in space if I have a spaceship.
What would you do to an alien?
Just look at it.
That's it?
We might have tea.
Boring. I would have tea with an alien, but then I would also fuck it. Don't leave me. Melanie, are you gone because of alien sex?
No, I'm here. How would you have sex with an alien if you don't know where the holes are?
I would just ask.
Oh.
It's like with humans.
Do you have to ask where they are?
You have to ask about everything. Let's practice. You start with, how are you?
I don't want... Why do you start with that?
it's polite.
What if you don't want it to be nice?
Then you start with kissing and you go from there. Melanie?
Twins in the library, late afternoon. A giant bucket of slime phloem sits in front of them.
Phloem!
I see it.
This is a game changer. This is what we've been missing.
It looks like Dippin' Dots stuck in Jell-O.
I know, I want to eat it.
Probably toxic.
Definitely toxic. Deliciously toxic. Want to touch it first?
No, it should be you. It was your idea.
I was hoping you would say that.
Melanie shoves her hand into the bucket.
Is it good?
Chills. I just got chills.
Is that really what it sounds like?
No, it's not really wet enough. I mean, you know.
No, I don't.
You've never? Like, the end of your toothbrush or something?
What? Gross. No.
Never. Never?
No, Jesus Christ, who are you?
I don't do it anymore. Just at first.
When was it first?
Years ago. I was 11, I think.
So what you've just told me is that you used to do this while we shared a room. Like, while I was there.
Sorry.
How did you even know what you liked back then?
The same way I know what I like now.
Yeah, but how? How do you know what you like now?
I just know. It just feels good.
Let me touch it. This is weird.
You have to really get your hands in there.
They are in there.
Squish it in your fists. It's gotta spill over your fingers.
Melanie tries to help. Their hands meet inside the phloem.
Don't. I don't want to do this.
Is it freaking you out that you don't know what your own vagina sounds like?
No, I don't care. I don't want to know. The phloem is gross.
Do you think you'll be like 30 years old before you lose your virginity?
Melanie, I don't want to do this right now.
I bet you'll be like 35, right around the time that your body starts getting old and decrepit. And by then, I will have been fucking for years. Actually, I meant to tell you this before. I think I'm going to lose my virginity on a plane. I just kind of sense it, you know? Anyway, you'll be ancient, and you'll finally let someone put it in you, like in an old Victorian house in the countryside or something. And I'll be so proud of you.
You are really ugly sometimes.
What? It's a joke. I'm joking.
You're not as funny as you think you are. I've been meaning to tell you.
We have an episode to record. Sit back down.
I'm just gonna go to the bathroom for a while. I'll be back.
Oh, is it a big one?
Not everything is about poop or sex. Some things are just boring. Whatever, yes, it'll be an event. So if you want to record the phloem bits while I'm gone, I wouldn't mind.
Okay, Godspeed. Be brave.
Teresa leaves quickly. Melanie stares at the phloem. Teresa in a bathroom stall, talking to Lily. Melanie in the library, with the phloem recording.
Hey.
Hey. Why did you disappear?
I had a thing. I just needed to... I don't know. Sorry.
It's okay. Don't apologize. You are always saying sorry, even if you don't need to.
Will you teach me?
Teach you what?
All the questions I'm supposed to ask.
Oh.
You don't have to.
No. I will.
It's just that you seem to have done it before.
Yes. What do you want to know?
Pretend there's someone I love. If I was with an alien right now, and we already had tea, and we wanted to do those other things, how would I start?
Are we being polite?
No.
Okay. First, you kiss.
Anywhere?
Anywhere you want. Maybe lips. Or chest. The pointy bones on the chest. What are they called?
Collarbones.
Yes. Probably this alien has those.
What does it feel like?
Spit all over, but warm.
And is that good?
Depends. Do you like the alien as more than friends?
I like the way they talk to me.
What do they say?
They say...
Do it again.
They ask me things about my day, and they remember things about me.
Yes?
And they let me finish sentences because they know I have good, important things to say.
Keep going.
And then...
And then you touch them. Wherever little alien wants to be touched, And you know you found a good spot because they make noises.
Melanie looks down at herself, covered in phloem. She leaves the library.
I wish you could show me. I wish I could hear them so I know which are good.
I want to see you.
What? How?
Video chat? Melanie? Hello? I want to see you. Don't leave me.
I didn't.
Did I scare you?
No, I just don't know about this.
You don't trust me?
No, I do. I'm just not really supposed to be talking to you. I made a promise.
I really want to see you. Video?
Okay.
Melanie enters the bathroom. She washes her hands in the sink. Teresa stares at her screen. A man is there. He is shirtless, and he is smiling.
Hi. I had to see you.
Who are you?
Teresa? Are you in there?
Your voice sounds different this way.
Are you still pooping?
Is there someone else there?
Is someone in the stall with you?
Is it your sister?
Who's with you? I'm coming in.
Oh. She got all the good genes.
What are you... Who is that?
It's nice to meet you. Finally.
Teresa, who is this?
Why is she calling you Teresa?
Because that's her name. Why don't you have a shirt on? Stop smiling like that.
Oh. You've been lying to me. That's disappointing.
Teresa doesn't lie. Why are you ignoring me? I'm asking a question.
Teresa, I am not dangerous. Don't hang up. I love you. You remember everything we talked about? That's all still me. I am that person.
Hang up.
I want you to feel less alone. That's all I want.
Teresa, hang up.
Don't hang up. Look at me. Do something for me. Pretend your sister is the alien.
Teresa, stop!
What do we start with? Do you remember?
Teresa looks at Melanie.
Imagine. Every morning you eat a bowl of cereal in the exact same way and in the exact same amount of time. One morning you drink your milk to the bottom and discover a teeny tiny Harry Styles just vibing. He disrupts your routine. He gets in the way. He's not doing anything, but he's doing everything. You compost him and move on with your day. You are a grown-up and you have no time for him.
Imagine. You want to get old with someone, but Harry Styles is so young. Several weeks earlier, twins alone in the library, Melanie laying with her head in Teresa's lap.
Sometimes I think I want him to just watch.
Like watch you with someone else?
No, it's not that. I don't even want him to watch me have sex. I just want him to watch me.
That's creepy.
No, not like watching me, not like a stalker situation. Although that could be pop too. I just mean like really looking at me. In my eyes. Kind of like how you're looking at me now, with full attention. But with him, it would be like, well, we're at breakfast at our kitchen table in our home, and he looks at me because it's all he wants to do. Or he looks at me because I look really radiant when I first wake up. Or maybe we're at like a fair or something in the summer, and we're looking at all the prize pigs, like we're in Charlotte's Web. And he watches me watching the pigs. He's just there with me, and it's nice. It's warm.
I like that. Sometimes I want him to hurt me.
like, put as much of his body inside my body as he possibly fucking can and obliterate me.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Teresa, you sound like me.
I know. And you sound like me.
I know!
Do you think we should write it in?
We should write it all in. Everything.
We can't do everything. It won't make sense.
Yes, it will.
No, it won't. She can't be wanting him to just watch her exist and then also wanting him to ruin her.
Yes, she can. That's love, baby.
And how would you know?
Because I can see the future, and in the future, I'm in love with a tall, dark, and handsome man who may or may not be Harry Styles, who may or may not enjoy doing everything in the conceivable universe with me.
So love is just doing everything with one other person? That's so boring.
No, it's not. It's romantic. Shut up. Don't make this sad.
Do you really want someone to be with you all the time? Like, every second of the day? I can't think of anyone I could stand for that long.
What about me?
What about you?
I'm with you all the time.
Yeah, but it's not the same.
Yeah, but you just said...
Yeah, but you know what I meant. You don't count.
Why don't I count?
Because you just don't.
Why?
Because...
Why?
Because it's different. I don't feel like you're this other person. You're like me, a part of me.
Are you being cute right now?
The very worst, most annoying part of me.
I can't believe I got you to say
that! The disgusting, awful, horrible, evil part of me.
You love me so much!
Bold of you to be doing this while your head is in my lap.
Say you love me.
I could do anything to you right now.
Say three words. Say it.
You were powerless in this situation.
Say it. Say it!